Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back after the break. You're watching Towards the Origin in conversation with Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman, a graduate from Al-Azhar University and the respected, or one of the respected Imam and Khateeb of the famously known mosque, Regent's Park Mosque. Our tonight's topic for discussion is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the hero, the role model that we should all aspire to follow, that we should all follow to the footstep that our Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left for us, the legacy that's there, the methodology that's there. But in today's world, in 21st century, especially in 2018, sometimes we struggle to even highlight certain fundamental issues proudly. Why is that? What is the main reason for us not to aspire him as our role model? Why do we take today the role model that perhaps might not be familiar with our faith, perhaps nothing to do with our faith, but yet we aspire, and all our inspiration are revolving around the assets or wealth people have accumulated. All of this, and inshallah many more, we'll try and dispel in this segment of the episode, and perhaps a little bit find out more about our Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and how can we implement certain factors, certain legacy that he's left with us in today's world. Now, Sheikh, coming back to our discussion, we have heard a lot of influential personalities talking about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Alayhi
sallam.
এখানে তো কোনো সন্দেহ নাই। আপনি যেভাবে clearly বলেছেন, the critics of Islam are the best example if they comment positively about about the people who they strongly disagree with. কিন্তু এখন কথা হচ্ছে, এই সব তো ঠিক আছে, তার জায়গাই আছে। Now, as Muslim, আমরাও জানি this is right, or certain aspect is right. Kintu, when we're in a professional dimension, when we circle ourselves with non-Muslim, for some reason, we don't feel proud to talk about certain aspect of Islam or certain aspect of our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, or certain aspect of his character. Why is that? Even though we are proud Muslims, yes, and we all verbally testify that.
Yes, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I believe it is because the lack of knowledge about this great Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, we are ourselves, we are not clear about certain claims that are made by the non-Muslims and probably the critics of Islam. আমি মনে করি যে আমাদের নিজেদের তেমন পর্যাপ্ত পরিমাণ জ্ঞান রসুল করিম সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লামের নয়, এবং বিশেষ করে যে কথাগুলো, যে ক্লেমগুলো অমুসলিমরা অর্থাৎ এবং যারা ইসলামের দুশ্মন যারা আছেন, ক্লেমগুলোকে যারা দুশ্মনরা যেটা করে, এই সম্পর্কে আমাদের ধারণা আরও বেশি কম। তো এই জন্য আমি মনে করি সাম অফ আস উই আর নট হ্যাপি, ও উই আর নট কনফিডেন্ট এনাফ টু স্পিক অ্যাবাউট দি নবল প্রফেট মোহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম ইন পাবলিক, ইন্ড উই আর নট কনফিডেন্ট এনাফ টু শেয়ার about this great individual with others. But of course, like, when we know more about somebody, the more we can share, the more we are confident.
এখানে কি মসজিদের দায়িত্ব নেই বা ইসলামী অর্গানাইজেশন বা চ্যারিটেবল অর্গানাইজেশন যারা আছে, কি দায়িত্ব নাই টু এডুকেট দি মুসলিমস অন হাউ টু এক্সেল ইন ডুইং অর কনভেইং সার্টেন আসপেক্ট অফ ইসলাম টু আদার্স?
Yes, I think in general that the topic of da'wah is quite forgotten amongst the Muslims. And the more we focus on da'wah, then of course we'll understand that these issues will come up and we'll have to deal with these issues, like especially the controversial issues like the polygamy in Islam, like for example the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, the capital punishments and many other things which are not quite clear to many people. And of course there are people who are every day they're trying to brainwash the Muslims as well as non-Muslims and trying to turn them around against Islam. And there are intentional attempts and intentional programs are put in place to make give a negative view about Islam.
Now, it is true, কিন্তু এখানে আমাদেরও কিছু দায়িত্ব আছে। আমরা কয়েকটি ডকুমেন্টারি বানাতে পারি in response to that. How many qualified Muslim journalists are there? How many trained qualified Muslim orators are there, or political or perhaps any other neutral commentators are there that can defend the true aspect
of Islam? Exactly. So we as Muslim, we actually have to produce like qualified people, those who can speak and those who can really address these issues, but with logic, with hikmah, with wisdom, with knowledge. Now, let's just come back to a little bit about some of the statements of the non-Muslims. Let's continue. We've been talking about the statements of the non-Muslim thinkers, অমুসলিম দার্শনিক, চিন্তাবিদ এবং ঐতিহাসিকরা রাসূলে করিম সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি সাল্লাম সম্পর্কে কী বলেছিলেন এবং ওনাদের কী ধারণা ছিল আমাদের প্রিয় নবী রাসূলে করিম সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি সাল্লাম সম্পর্কে। অলসো উই ফাইন্ড ইন অ্যাকচুয়ালি বাইবল, ইন দ্য বাইবল, হোলি বাইবল, উই ফাইন্ড দ্য প্রেডিকশন অফ দ্য অ্যারাইভাল অফ প্রফেট মোহাম্মদ সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি সাল্লাম ওয়াজ মেনশন ইন দ্য বাইবল, which many people don't know. Many non-Muslims, many Christians do not know. And I have heard that in original Bibles, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was mentioned as the praised one, which has been taken out as well. But indication of the noble Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is in the Bible, and that's confirmed by the scholars of the comparative religions. So let's see what mentioned in the Bible about Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. In King James Version, John 16, verse 12 to 14. It says, I have yet many things to say. So Jesus, peace be upon him, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, is saying that I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. However, when he, the spirit of the truth, is come, meaning this is an indication of the noble Prophet Muhammad, the spirit of the truth, or the Bible, the spirit of the truth, jokon ashben. Ebong the spirit of the truth, kay comparative religion jara expert scholar, honorable tisin ini Rasul Karim Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So when the spirit of the truth come, he will guide you into all truth. Uni tumader ke shotter dike niye jaben, jokon spirit of the truth ashben. For he shall not speak of for himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. He shall glorify me. So Jesus, peace be upon him, Isa alayhi salam, is saying in the Bible that he will glorify me. The spirit of the truth, joni ashben Rasul Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam kotha bola jokhon uni ashben. He will say the good things about me. So he will glorify me, for he shall receive of mine and shall show it unto you. So the arrival, or that Rasul Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam abirbab, unar je agamon ei prithibir moddhe, eta kintu holy Bible er moddhe kintu bola hocche ebong eta mention ache, ebong etai kintu comparative religion, or that tulonamulok dharmer jara expert scholar jara alemuddin jara achen, unara boltechen ei Bible er moddhe kintu Rasul Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam er kotha bola hocche King James version er moddhe. Then we also find there are other scholars, like there is somebody called Michael Haychart. I'm sure you've heard of his name. Mm-hmm. Michael Haychart of Hart Foundation in 1932. Michael Haychart kintu ekjon ottonto American ekjon ottonto boro chintabid chilen, professor chilen, uddhapok chilen, ebong professor of astronomy, uni scholar of astronomy, or the planet science er uni professor chilen, physics and the history of science in USA, speaks on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is saying, let's see what he says. So he wrote a book called The Hundred, and in that book he spoke about 100 most influential men in the history of mankind. And you know, he, in his number, in his serial, he had no choice but to put Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be the top on the of the list. Ebong uni bolchen je keno Rasul Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke number 1 listed moduni rekhechen as most probably ebong successful byaktitto manob jatir itihasher moddhe. Uni bolchen, my choice of Muhammad to lead the list of the world's most influential persons may surprise some readers and may be questioned by others, but he was the only man in history who was supremely successful on both the religious and the secular level. So he is saying that he was successful in religious as well as in the worldly level. And this is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he mentioned that statement in his book, famous book, The Hundred, a ranking of the most influential persons in history, New York, 1978. Page 33. And this is where Michael Haychart of Hart Foundation, a Jewish scholar of astronomy, physics, and history, he is speaking about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said that Muhammad is top on the list. Yes, subhanallah. A non-Muslim writing a book about Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about 100 most influential men, and he puts Muhammad to be the first. And we have to understand the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last prophet. He came way after all other prophets. Amader priyo nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam uni kintu Isa alaihis salamer pore ashechen, Musa alaihis salamer onek pore ashechen, kintu tar pore Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam unar position ke high kore rakha hoyeche. Ebong etai kintu Quran al-Karim er moddhe Allah pak bolen, wa rafa'na laka dhikrak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in surah Alam Nashrah Lak, he said, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I have raised your status, no matter what they say, no matter what they will speak about you, but verily I have raised your status. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is high, he is a hero, he is a role model, and he will be the highest, insha'Allah, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. So this is the statement of Michael Hachert in his book, The 100. And then we find Mahatma Gandhi, and we don't need to go too far. Mahatma Gandhi is again an Indian. His actual name is Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. In 1869 to 1948, an Indian thinker, statesman, Rashtrashasak, among nationalist leader. And of course, everybody knows Mahatma Gandhi. He was a great leader. And Mahatma Gandhi is again speaking about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I think the Hindu world should learn and should study about the statement that mentioned, or the remarks that are made by Mahatma Gandhi. So he said, "I became more than ever convinced that it was not the sword that won a place for Islam in those days in the scheme of life." Now you see many people that say Islam was spread through sword, through force. Many people say that. And this is one of the claims made by critics and the haters of Islam. This Islam was spread through sword. Or that Islam talwarir maddhome eta prachar ebong prosar hoyeche. Eta jodi hoto, tahole ajke ekhon amra kintu Middle Easter je 9 million non-Muslim achen, onaderke amra non-Muslim dekhtam na. Karon Islam ruled Middle East for how many centuries, how many years? But if Muslims forced anybody, then they would force these non-Muslims in the Middle East before anybody else. So Muslims never forced anybody to become Muslim. And even in Quran, it's very clearly mentioned, لا إكراه في الدين. There's no compulsion in the religion. So he said that Mahatma Gandhi is saying, "I became more than ever convinced that it was not the sword that won the place for Islam in those days in the scheme of life. It was the rigid simplicity." Or that Rasul Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam just simple life chilo. We need to very simple chilen. And yet there is a saying that ultimate sophistication is in simplicity. So he was very simple, rigid simplicity. The utter self-effacement. Unar nijeke uni bilupto kore diyechilen. Or that for the sake of others, he never looked at himself. He spoke sometimes about himself to express and to clarify his status. Like, for example, he said, "Ana Sayyid Waladi Adam, I'm the best of the children of Adam." And then he said, "وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ وَلَا فَخْرٍ." He said, there's no pride in it, there's no arrogance. But and then he said, "وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ." In Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, speak something that good happens in your life. Or that apnar jibone moddhe kono bhalo jinish apni jodi orjon koren tokhon eta apni onno sathe alap korte paren, but without any arrogance and pride.
Now this is where the problem comes in. Now fair enough, some people might say it's mentioned in the Quran, we understand that, but then again amra ekhon ke samaje dekhchi je amader jodi kichu bhalo hoye thake, we spread it in such a way as if I am the only person who has achieved this, or I have done this, I have acquired it. Now the basic theme line hote je Allah jodi, if it was without His will, then obviously we wouldn't have achieved it. Now, because of that, unintentionally, pride and arrogance kicks in.
Yes.
Now, how do we balance it today?
You see, there's a Quranic verse which says, there is a very important saying, "Hatha min fadli Rabbi." Many of us we know this. Jatai amader jibone moddhe amra orjon korte kintu Allah pak rabbul alaminer fazl. Without His mercy and without His help, we couldn't achieve anything. We couldn't even walk, we couldn't even speak. Amra hatte partam na, amra kotha bolte partam na, amra khete partam na. Everything that we achieved in this world with the help of Allah the Almighty, now, and through, of course, the means.
Now, let me give you an example. Like, for example, the results came out, whether it be the GCSE or A-level results came out. Now, everyone is congratulating the students that have acquired it, or perhaps the parents that have worked hard.
Yes, very few people really speak about
how often do you hear that actually because of the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was able to achieve the results and the parents' hard work? We don't hear that.
Yes, so, I mean, all of us, we need to understand that. Sometimes, you see, our problem is when we were successful, we say, you know, we have done this, you have done that, you know, we tried our best. When something goes wrong, you see, like, you know, it's your fault.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying? Like, we try to point fingers at others and we try to give blames to others when something goes wrong. But actually, everything, success or failure, is originally from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But all we can do is we can try. So I think whoever succeeded and whoever got the best good qualifications in exam results. First of all, congratulations to all these young children and students. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless you. May Allah make you successful in this life, in this world, and in the next world. But don't forget that all of this success is coming from Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, by the help of Allah.
But in Monarch
None of this we could achieve without the help of
that's
Allah.
That's true. Okay, the Monarch Tabi Atske Gintomi success achieved Korotsi Agamita result Balahova, that's no there's no guarantee.
Exactly,
for that.
Yeah, things can change.
Yes,
and sometimes we do very good results in GCSEs, and maybe we don't get the good result in A levels and in degree and in other levels.
So that's why I think humbleness ekta jinish ache. Acha arekta jinish ekhane ami jodi bolte chai je we know certain evil eye.
Yes.
যে আমরা এত ভালো ফলাও করে প্রসার করছি আমার ভালোটা আমার ভালো কাজ বা আমার অর্জন বা
অসাধারণ
কিন্তু এখানে আবার ইভিল আই বলে কিছু আছে what should we do
excellent again so this is something that we do also a lot in the social media আমাদের social media মধ্যে কিন্তু অনেক কিছু আছে যে আমরা কোথায় যাচ্ছি কি খাচ্ছি you know what food we are having imagine আপনি চিন্তা করে দেখেন আমরা কিন্তু একটা ভালো খাবার এখানে খাচ্ছি কিন্তু আমাদের দেশে বাংলাদেশ থেকে একজন বসে দেখতেছে সে কিন্তু এই খাবারটা কখনো পাচ্ছে না হাউ ডু ইউ ফিল
না বেশিরভাগ দূরে যাওয়ার এই দেশেও অনেক মানুষ আছে আমাদের মতো হতে খেতে পাচ্ছে না
জি জি সো উই হ্যাভ টু রিয়েলি ফিল ফর আদার পিপল ইউ নো উই হ্যাভ টু সি হাউ উড আই ফিল ইফ আই ওয়াজ ইন দ্যাট সিচুয়েশন সো ওয়াই আর উই টেম্পটিং আদার পিপল আমরা কেন অন্যকে কিন্তু এই দুঃখ দিচ্ছি
আবার এখান থেকে আরো
আমার জীবনের যে আমার পার্সোনাল লাইফে কি হচ্ছে এখানে আমরা কি খাচ্ছি কোথায় বসছি এটা সব কিছু আমাদের শেয়ার করতে হবে না উই ডোন্ট হ্যাভ টু শেয়ার এভরিথিং উইথ পিপল
আর আরেকটা জিনিস আমি শেয়ার করতে চাচ্ছি অ্যাজ বিকজ ইউ আর এন ইমাম পারহ্যাপস ইউ মাইট হ্যাভ ডিল উইথ দিস কাইন্ড অফ সিচুয়েশন যে একজন হয়তো দিয়েছেন এটা যার জন্য আরেকটি পরিবারে কিন্তু আগুন লেগে যাচ্ছে দেখো সো এন্ড সো ইজ গোইং অন হলিডে সো এন্ড সো ইজ জেলাসি এন্ড ইউ আর নট প্রোভাইডিং মি উইথ দিস বেসিক
ইয়েস এগেইন সি দিস ইজ এগেইন জেলাসি Wallahi, I can tell you, unnecessary pictures, taking pictures unnecessarily, unnecessary videos, unnecessary sharing anything, or that oprojone,
anything too much,
anything that is, bina oprojone, amra share kori, photo tuli, video amra record kori, egular kintu khoti khubi beshi. There are lots of side effects of those things, and I wonder when some of the scholars just say don't take pictures. Of course, there's a debate on that, but what I'm saying, none of the scholars would say that. Take things, photos or videos unnecessarily.
Exactly.
So when we record, the people who actually take a lot of photos, the tendency or the intention behind that is to share. I've heard there are people addicted actually in taking photos yes. and selfies. And it's all about just taking photos, subhanAllah. I mean, people forgot their original aim of the life.
And not only that, after they've been 100 years old, community, unfortunately, perhaps in the other community as well, how beautiful your house is, how good your extension of the house is, how beautiful yes. your children's are.
Yes.
And sometimes the worst thing is even people sharing intimate pictures of conjugal relationship.
Well,
do you understand?
Yes.
Perhaps to us, to the outer world.
And also, I
be.
Must mention, like some of us, we are, we always want to show our partners to others. Okay. And we have that tendency in society. So, we have to be really we have to review ourselves. If we are claiming to be the followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and part of this great individual that we're talking about, then we have to learn lessons from his life. Because why would he be the most successful if he didn't have these great qualities? Now, we need to align ourselves with the tradition, with the life, with the way, and with the behavior and with the conduct of our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Now, coming back to the verse that you have mentioned, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ.
Yes.
So then, even the ni'mah that Allah has given, one thing people fail to understand, isn't that true? That ni'mah is with the iman.
Yes.
Is the ni'mah without iman?
I mean, again, this ni'mah is again to do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's for Allah. And the izzah, the honor that you can talk about, that you can be proud, but with your faith, with your values, with your religion, you can be proud, but not for the individual and personal interest, personal reasons.
Okay.
You see, this is the difference. Now, Mahatma Gandhi is speaking about the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Mahatma Gandhi ki bolte chen amader nabi karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Uni bolchen the rigid simplicity chilen uni utter self-effacement of the Prophet, the scrupulous regard for his pledges, or that uni khubi noitik ebong bibekshampanno chilen, scrupulous. Noitik ebong bibeksham mono chilen, regard for his pledges, his intense devotion to his friends and followers. Othat unar sahabai karam ebong unar jara onushari jonno uni unar jibon ke uni bilin ko radiyallahu anhu Rasulullah Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam for his followers, and that's a great leader, sign of a great leader. So he's saying that his intense devotion to his friends and followers, his intrepidity, his fearlessness, okutoboy uni chilen bir uni kubi bir chilen, his fearlessness, his absolute trust in God, Allah, and in his own mission. So he was really, he did what he really believed. So his certainty, his yaqeen was really strong. And then he said, these and not the sword carried everything before them and surmounted every trouble. So every trouble he surmounted, he passed. Uni otikrom kore shima, protecta trouble ke bishir, uni otikrom kore, uni chole shijilin. Uni chilin Rasulullah Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran about him, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. In the life of the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have the best example. Tumi kuna tumi role model chao, tumi dignit dishuk chao, tumi kuna hero chao, tahole tumi Rasulullah Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam jibon dekho.
Tar mani hotse ekhane shudhu religiously ba spiritual element e dekha hocche na, rajnoitik bhabe politically even the leader
sense,
should be seen as Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him.
Exactly, and this is the reason why people are studying noble Prophet Muhammad in the universities, in high prestigious universities.
Now,
I mean the non not Islamic.
Now, the reason why I say that is because some people have got the notion that now politically you don't need to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Well, how would he be successful if he was really not a leader? Why would the Britannica say that he was a most religious and political figures? So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we can't leave, you know, he was a complete individual. He was a complete shakhsiya. يعني رجل يعني الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كان شخص متكامل. He's a complete man. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
So that means we can't pick and choose, rather accept in totality.
And I really feel sad, wallahi, when I go to the occasions of the Muslims, that how we disregard and how we ignore the teaching of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our personal and family occasions. We don't really seem to take his lessons in weddings, in biye shadi, amader je program gulo amader paribarik ebong amader samajik program gulo hoy, ote amra kintu Rasulullah Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke completely outside kamra kore fele dei. We just disregard him.
Very true. Our time is very limited and we're coming to the end. In last 30 seconds, what would you summarize?
So I would say that if the non-Muslim scholars and thinkers are speaking so highly about Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, jodi omuslimra eto sundor bhabe Rasulullah Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam proshongsha korechen, tahole amra musalmanra amra ki kori? Amader daitto ki? Amader daitto hocche amader role model, amader je bir, amader neta, amader je role model adorsho, in every sense hero Rasulullah Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And believe me, when we adhere ourselves, amra jokon unar জীবনকে আমরা অনুসরণ করি, তখন আমাদের জীবনের মধ্যে আমরা সাকসেস এবং আমরা কামিয়াবি দেখতে পারি. এবং আপনারা দেখছেন সারা বিশ্বের মধ্যে কেন যারা ইসলামের দুশ্মনরা রাসূলের করিম সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লামকে টেনশন করতেছে, এটা কিন্তু রাসূলের করিম সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়াসাল্লাম ফেইলিয়ার নয়, এটা ওনার সাকসেস. This is the success and achievement of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because they fail to speak, so they do things to hurt Muslims.
Jazakallah khair. I would have loved to discuss more about this topic, but time is up. And inshallah, thank you very much once again for joining the program.
Wallahi barakallahu fikum.
With this, my dear viewers, we have come to the conclusion of our tonight's discussion. We've discussed Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the light of a role model, a hero, a person that we can follow in every footstep of our life, whether it be the political dimension, whether it be the spiritual dimension, whether it be the educational dimension. In every dimension that we have in our world today, we can follow the legacy and the footstep of our beloved Prophet, peace be upon him. It's our shortfall, it's our limited understanding and knowledge that we cannot fulfill our basic obligation because of our limited understanding of the faith. Inshallah, from this program, I'd like to congratulate all of those, our brothers and sisters, those who have set for their GCSE and A-levels. They've done very, very well. But remember, this is not the success. This is just the beginning. Inshallah, our ultimate success should not only be successful in this world, but in the hereafter. And how can we do that? By ensuring that we adhere and we adapt and we enhance our religious understanding as well as the worldly knowledge that we gain from this world to better our life and to better the life of the society that we live in. Inshallah, we'll discuss or continue to discuss our discussion in our next episode. Till we meet again, subhanakallahu wa hamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Shaykh Allah khair, Shaykh. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.